Hi everyone, it's Michael Eilbrock from Diesel Laptops. This is going to be part two of showing the software for the Diesel tablet, and we're going to look at actuation tests next. So let's go to actuation tests, click on that, and then here this is showing all the different bi-directional actuations that you can do. So let's do a Let's see what we can do here. We've got cut out the injectors, test cylinder performance. Oh, diagnose the turbo actuator. Let's do this one. So let's click on this. It's asking to make sure that the entry conditions are fulfilled, and they are, so I'm gonna hit okay again. And now the next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna start the test. So we're doing a turbo actuator sweep. And the actuator sweep is finished. The mechanism and actuator are within their calibrated limits. So now it's telling me to key off the ignition for 15 seconds. So I'm going to key it off. And now it's counting down. You have to do this after you do every actuation, by the way. All right, now it's telling me to key on the ignition. And we're back to the activation page. All right, so that's just an example for doing an actuation on the engine side. Now, let's get out of here and let's go to customer parameters. So I'm going to click on that. And there's some parameters here that you can change with this tool. So if you owns several trucks, you have some drivers, and you don't like it that they got a lead foot, well, check this out. You can go to vehicle speed limit. You hit OK. And you can change the speed limit. So I'm just going to take my finger and just tap on the number 68. And then here you can change the number. So let's make it, instead of 68, let's put it down to 60. And let's hit OK. And let's hit program. And the parameter has been set successfully. So now it's at 60 miles an hour right here, okay? But say you want to put it back to what it was before. Well, that's easy. All you have to do is hit restore, click on it. And you're good. Okay, so let's get out of this actuation test page for the parameters. Go back to the menu. And let's look at special functions. So this is pretty cool. You can change your injector codes, reset the common rail pressure release valve, disable the EGRD rate. So if you're having an issue with that and you need to get the truck off the side of the side onto the side of the road, you can. You can also install and calibrate your VGT turbocharger actuator, and then you can enable or disable engine idle shutdown timer, read CalID and CVN and check the engine number. So there's a lot of cool features in here. So now let's go back. And then we're going to end this video here, but then we're going to, for the next part, we're going to go to looking at data stream.